All right, Sean. Let's let the folks know about emerald ash borer. I understand it's in the state of Tennessee. What do we need to know?
Listen, the emerald ash borer is known as the green monster. It's it's in 47 counties in the state of Tennessee. It was found in 2010 in Knox County in Knoxville. It's apparently moving rapidly to the west, and this is an opportunity for us to get informed about this insect and the damage that it causes to our ash.
Okay. Now, speaking of that damage, what kind of damage does it cause?
The ash borer, it attacks the fractionist species, which is the green ash, the white ash, all our ash species, and also a landscape tree, which is our French tree. Mm. Right now, it's in the pupation stage. It's about to emerge out as an adult, and that's where you get the D-shaped exit hole on these ash trees. And then it goes out, it feeds 1 to 2 weeks on neighboring ash trees. They can fly up to half a mile away from those ash trees, but they normally just fly close around. They lay their eggs. They can also lay up to 65 to 90 eggs. Their lifespan, which could be up to 1 to 2 years. And then the eggs hatch out, and they lay these in the crevices of the trees. Mm-hmm. And the eggs hatch out, and they start to feed on the phloem of the tree, which that's where your water and nutrients move into your tree. Cut that off and it girdles your tree and it starts to die.
Okay.
This insect is very destructive. It probably will have an historical effect on the state of Tennessee because of the destructiveness, and it doesn't have a host to really control it. Mm. And we haven't got a hand on how to control this insect. So
okay.
The emerald ash borer is something that in West Tennessee, we should get prepared for, offset some of the cost. You know, there may be some litigation issues with it, because if it kills ash trees of significant size, then trees falling over on private property, yeah, and people are going to want their compensation of the damage they caused from those trees.
Wow, so it's going to be a major problem.
I think it's going to be a major problem.
Wow. How did it get here anyway?
The emerald ash borer was transported through wood, okay, crates, weathering in crates, weathering in fractionist species trees from different states.
Okay.
And that's why we're trying to control the movement of firewood, mm-hmm, and also our ash trees that are sold in our nurseries.
Okay.
That's how it's transported throughout the state.
Wow, that's going to really hurt the homeowners, because French trees are beautiful trees, and we, yes, actually encourage folks to plant French trees.
Right, right.
Wow. So the emerald ash borer may be a problem for us then.
Emerald ash borer is going to be a problem for us, and I think we're in a situation now where we can get prepared for it. Homeowners, I encourage you to start scouting, going out and doing some observation of your yards. If you have ash trees, observe them. Look and see if you see D-shaped holes. And then contact our local agency, the Department of Agriculture, mm-hmm, and we'll move on from there.
Okay. Now, somebody's probably going to ask, what's the control? I mean, how do you control it? Or can you control it?
There are some labels out there, imidacloprid, dinotefuran, mm-hmm, and emamectin benzoates are some of the chemicals used to control it.
Okay.
There's no way to avoid the cost, mm-hmm, because it's going to cost to apply these chemicals,
sure,
and then it's also going to cost for you to remove trees when it makes it here. So you got to think of the urban environment, and then you also got to think of the rural environment.
Right.
That's going to be a cost on both of those different sectors of forestry.
And so I guess for these systemic insecticides, I mean, you have to apply those every year, don't you?
Yes, you do. You have to apply them every year. And the emamectin is even more expensive because it needs to be injected.
Oh, wow.
Yes. So
definitely going to be expensive.
Yes.
Yeah, to do it that way.
So in our natural areas, just say for instance, Overton Park, we have enormous size ash trees. I think that would be a place to target to try to preserve what we wanted. The specimens that we want to preserve, let's start preserving those in there, because that's a beautiful ornament for the city of Memphis.
Okay.
Yes.
Wow. How many ash trees do you think we have in the state of Tennessee?
I think we estimated about 90 million, with the cost of about $2 billion.
Wow.
Statewide, $260 million with the cost of about $9 million. Yes.
Wow. So these trees, of course, the ash trees are infected by this pest, the emerald ash borer.
Mm-hmm.
How long before the tree actually starts dying, though?
Those trees start dying within 1 to 2 years, depending on the health of that tree.
Right.
If that tree is a healthy tree, then it may take 3 to 4 years. But the insect is he's going to attack the weaker tree.
Sure.
But the healthier tree is acceptable.
Wow.
Because he's attacking all fractional species.
Wow.
So he'll prefer the weak, and then he's going to, once he get the weak, then he go after the stronger.
Wow.
Yes.
No escaping the emerald ash borer. That's what it sounds like.
No.
I mean, it attacks the weak tree and your stronger trees.
Right. So planting and budgeting is key to offset some of the cost. So while we have time, let's start to scout our yards. Let's start to observe and look for this insect. And once it's detected, then we need to go to our state agencies and we need to move forward from there.
Okay.
On what we're going to do, what procedure we need to take to help the city.
Wow.
West Tennessee.
So tell me, is the Forestry Service, TDA, I mean, do y'all set traps, you know, for the emerald ash borer?
They have been trapping out in the east, and okay. I'm sure that we're going to start trapping here in the west.
Okay.
Just see, can we find any detection of them.
Wow. And I've seen the emerald ash borer, of course, in pictures. Beautiful looking pest, though.
Beautiful.
But it does a lot of damage, and again, you talked about it, but at least like the little galleries.
Tunneling, okay. Yes, right.
And you said that infects the phloem layer, and of course for folks, I mean, you know.
Pretty much girdles it.
It girdles the tree.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
Wow. So, again, this is going to be a huge problem. I'm glad we need folks to get on the front end of this.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. The front end. Let's get on the front end so we can offset and prepare, or homeowners just to prepare for that tree that you want to preserve in your yard. Or on your landscape, and also for our cities and cities and towns in West Tennessee. Let's be prepared for it and not take it for granted.
Sure.
Because it has a quiet stage. You detect it, you may find one specimen where it's detected, and it's quiet.
Right.
And on the fifth year, you just see die back all across your area of the state. So let's not be fooled by that quiet stage. If it's been detected in our county, then it's here.
All right, well, Sean, we appreciate the information. And again, we hope folks get on the front end of the emerald ash borer because it's going to be a problem.
Yes, sir.
Thank you much.
Uh-huh.